Hey guys, Carissa Rose here. This piece in this video is going to be a sort of self-portrait that I've been working on and off for the last couple of months. For this piece, I'm using 100-pound watercolor paper, and right now I'm using acrylic paints. And I like to water down acrylics, use them sort of like watercolors. You're not really supposed to on canvas, but I find on watercolor paper it has a really nice result. And unlike watercolors, it doesn't smudge with water afterwards, so it's kind of fun to work with. For this piece, I made a very specific point to be drunk during the entire time that I was painting and drawing it. So I only worked on it when I was intoxicated. I suppose I should have got drunk for the narration too, but it is early on Sunday, so I'm good. So I went in with some Sharpie markers for that black outline, and I'm going back over with more acrylic paint on the hair and stuff. For this piece, I just kind of took like a crappy selfie on my phone to use as a reference and pretty much freehanded it. I didn't want to use pencils underneath because it's really hard to erase pencils once you put paint over it. A lot of times I'll start some freehand painting and get like halfway through and decide, oh, I don't really like this piece, so I'm gonna not do it. Probably the only reason I even got this piece finished was just because I only worked on it a little bit here and there in between other pieces. Otherwise, I probably would have got bored with it. So this piece is sped up to 50 times speed. It took me about 4 hours actual drawing time. So at this point, I decided to go in with my Copic markers, which at the start of the video, I didn't have any, but I started doing some Copic marker drawings and wanted to see how they worked out on watercolor paper over the acrylics, and they worked really well. They had a really nice result, and they didn't like smudge or anything from the acrylics. Then I decided to go back in with a darker Copic marker to add some more depth in the hair. Sorry, by the way, that the paper keeps flipping all over the place. I just have a natural like curve when I draw with my right hand, and I like to turn the paper to help get that curve sometimes, but in future videos, I will practice harder on maybe taping the paper down so I can try to keep everything nice and centered so you can better see what I'm doing. It'll just take some practice, but I'll work on it. So now I'm going back and with some Prismacolor white colored pencil to get some highlights. I love doing highlights with colored pencil over paint or over markers. It really adds some great contrast, and it really helps everything to pop a lot better for your final piece. And Prismacolors are especially important for this because not many colored pencils are pigmented enough to go over stuff that well. But Prismacolors are super nice. So now I'm doing some stippling on the hair to show that the side is shaved, of course. And since I was drunk, of course, I procrastinated to the very end on working on the ear, which I shouldn't have waited till I was super drunk to do, because looking at it now, it looks kind of ratchet. For the background, I just went in with a bunch of water and a bunch of paint and splatters, and I used paper towels to pick up some of the color as I was going along. I let it dry quite a bit in between, which I didn't record waiting for it to dry. Then I went in with some more white acrylic paint for some highlights, and that is about it. And there's the piece all finished up. So thank you so much for checking out my latest video. I am going to be working on some tutorials in the next couple of weeks because I've been getting a lot of requests for a bunch of varieties of them. If you have any suggestions for any future videos you'd like to see, be sure to leave a comment. And be sure to check out my Etsy store, my Facebook and Instagram. I'll leave links in the description. Thanks, guys.